y'all, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make two really easy and really cute bee decor pieces. Stay tuned and I'll show you how to make both of them. Alrighty, y'all, let us get started. Look, I've got butterfly wing nails. I did those the other day and I really, really like them. But first, what we're going to need for this craft is an Easter egg. This is just a plastic Easter egg, came from Dollar Tree. We're going to need some beads, also from Dollar Tree. Now, I bought two packs. I got one black and one sort of like this natural color. I'm going to be using this black and yellow. So in order to get the yellow, you're also going to need some paint. I'm going to use this spray paint gloss bright idea. Now, this came from Lowe's. This is a Krylon Color Max paint and primer together. Yes, you can use acrylic paint if you don't have spray paint. Just a little bit of yellow. And we're also going to be using this twine from Dollar Tree. So let's get this open. Where's the end? Hold on. Okay, so we have our twine cut, and now we're going to take our Easter egg, and you see this is sort of like the rounded bottom, and this is the top here that's more oval shaped. We're going to be using the top, okay? So let's just cut this little bottom piece off and set that off to the side. And then I'm going to take our string here. Oops. See, it started to split. That's kind of tricky. But anyway, I'm just going to feed this down through this hole here, then pull it up the bottom, and then feed it up through this hole here, okay? This is what we have. Now look, if you have some of those Easter eggs that don't have the two holes, maybe it just has one hole, that's fine. Just double up your twine, and then feed that in through the hole, and then tie a knot. I was getting ready to say note. Tie a note to it. Tie a knot in the bottom, and that'll hold it in place. So let's see, because you see here, these are spaced kind of wide apart. I am going to make a mess. I'm going to tie this like so. Just tie a knot there. Whee! There we go. That's what we need. Okay. Now, we're going to be threading beads on here, so that means that we have to paint these. So I'm going to go ahead and take these outside. These, not these! These! I'm going to take these outside with my yellow spray paint here, and I'm going to paint them so that while they're drying, we can finish work on this. Okay? I'll be right back. Okay, so now we are waiting for our paint to dry. So I'm going to take my Easter egg here, and this is just a piece of cardboard. Let's set it here. Now these eggs from Dollar Tree are a little flimsy, okay? So try not to squeeze it or like press it down hard when you're working with them or tracing around or anything like that, because then you're going to distort them. So now let's cut that out. While we're waiting for our paint to dry, now let's start working on our little Skep here. So I have here a little river rock, and I'm just going to put that down in there. Why? To give it a little bit of weight, because these are very lightweight, and depending on where you're going to have this hanging or have it, you know, presented, it may not hang exactly the way you want it to. I know I've already been playing around with this. So I'm going to put one little river rock down in there before we glue on the bottom, okay? So when we glue on the bottom here, let's see which... It doesn't really matter which way, because I'm going to have this covered up. But be very careful with this. I'm just going to put a little bit of hot glue around the edges here, and then we're going to glue this to the bottom of our Easter egg. The twine that I have over here that we used for this is just a little bit too thin for going around the egg, but then again, the regular nautical rope that you get from Dollar Tree, that's a little too thick. So what I did, let's zoom out just a little bit here. So I cut a piece of it, and as you can see, it just divides into three strands. I'm going to untwist this piece here. I didn't even measure it. I just cut a piece. And then we're just going to pull it apart so that we can use one of these strands. Now you can buy spools like this that's about this thickness, but I'm trying to keep this as close to Dollar Tree as possible. There's our hair. Trying to keep it as close to Dollar Tree as possible. So that's why I'm using this. Okay, so now we're going to use this to wrap our little egg here. Now, because we tied a knot here, I think that's going to give us a pretty good start to get our rope glued down. Just try to be careful with how much glue you're putting on this. I'm just going to take that, and I'm just going to hold it down right like that. Go, go, gadget nails! And just let that glue sit there and harden up. Just make double sure that the glue is hardened up before you start wrapping it all the way around. I need to put another little blob right here. And just hold the end down like so, because you don't want that end coming off, okay? And everything will unravel. I'm unraveled enough. I don't need that. So let's let that glue set. I believe that glue has set up. So now I'm just going to put a tiny little bit more. And this is the difficult part, is just getting this first little part started. But once you get that started and you really start wrapping it around, it gets easier. It gets a lot easier, believe me. So this is all that we're doing with this. You're just adding your glue and just wrapping the rope around and around the egg. Okay, so our little egg is completely covered here. So now, you don't have to do this if you don't want to, but I'm going to. You can just continue wrapping the rope around the bottom here. As you can see, I ran out. I didn't cut my piece long enough, but I don't know what I'm just going to need. So I'll just have to get another piece. And then we're just going to continue just a little at a time, wrapping your rope around the bottom and around till you get to the center. This is done. And now I have this other glue gun heating up here. This is the Sure Bonder Cool Shot. Look down in the description box in the comments. I'll have links for you. But anyway, what do you use with the Cool Shot is you use their Cool Shot color sticks. Of course, they have clear ones as well. But it's super low temp. And if you don't have colored glue sticks, just use regular glue sticks and then just paint them with acrylic paint. I've said that in previous videos, but people always ask, well, if I don't have yellow, paint it. So let's decide what we want the front to be. That looks good. So what did I do here? What is this? This is just a tiny little piece of this rope that I glued into a circle for the entrance of our little skep here. And I'm just going to put a little bit of glue on there, and then we're going to stick it down. Now, the part where I joined it together, I'm going to put that at the bottom, okay? So we can cover that up with our colored glue stick. I got fuzzies on me. I've got like 10 crafts going at one time. Okay, because we're like in the first week of June, and I'm already filming for Halloween and Christmas, and I'm excited for some of the stuff I've got coming out this year. Okay, so let's set that there. Now, you know what? I left my paintbrush in the living room. Let me go get it. I'm going to take a little bit of black paint and just paint the inside here, like so. Just kind of scooping it out from the bottle, and we're going to paint this. So I believe that is done. So let's see if this Cool Shot has heated up yet. It does not take long at all to heat up, okay? Hold on, I'm just cleaning the nozzle off. So now we're going to take this and we're just going to put a little bit, like just around the entrance there. Don't get in a hurry with this, because like I said, it doesn't get very, very hot. So it is. What I was saying before my camera cut off was it doesn't get very hot, so the glue doesn't like run and flow, you know, like a regular high temp glue gun. Let's just trim this off there. So you just have to be extra careful. All right, so there's that. Now let us glue on one of these little B buttons. These came from Joann's. Now, of course, this couldn't be from Dollar Tree because they don't carry such things. But you had this, you had like this little shank on the back. I'm just going to cut that off. Now be careful, because that kind of holds on some of these pieces. I want to cut that off and then we're going to glue it down. Okay, so carefully. I like to put the glue like right there in the center so that, you know, it can still hold all the pieces together. And then let's just put that right there, like so. Now we're going to, I think, glue on another one. Let's see, somewhere like, oops, sorry. I meant to hold that in the other hand. I didn't. Sorry. Glue that right there. Okay. So how cute is that? So now let me go and check on the beads and see if they're dry. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to alternate threading our beads onto our rope like so. Just pulling it down all the way down to the bottom. Okay. That would be cute to hang from a rear view mirror. If the car wouldn't get so hot and melt your hot glue. But anyway, I'm just going to alternate these. Alternate the colors. My yellow ones are over here. So I'm just going to thread on however many I see fit. And then we're going to add a tassel and that'll be done. Okay, Now, if you have a problem with your twine here pushing through your beads, I just wrap the end. Gosh, my hands are filthy. I've got stuff all over them. I just wrap it with a piece of tape, and that helps you to push them through the beads. So now we're going to make a tassel, which is fairly easy. So I'm just going to take, let's get that over there. Fix that so that our little beads don't fall off. I just took a piece of cardboard, however the length that I want my tassel, and we're just going to start wrapping this twine around. Fine. Roll off the table. That's fine. I don't care anymore. I've been battling this thing. All right. I'm just going to wrap it however many times you think it make a decent sized tassel. And I think that'll be fine. Just cut it right there. Okay. Don't wrap it too tight or you won't be able to slide it off your cardboard. You just slide it off. And where is our loopy loop at the top? Let's see, did I pull that wrong? No. All right, so you just take that, and then we're going to take the end of this, go through there, and then just tie a nice sturdy knot. Okay, just kind of bring our loop down, and now we're going to cut the bottom. So, all right, we can trim off the ends here in a little bit when we get done, okay? So it does not have to be perfect. Where did my other piece? Here it is. Shut up, Amber. All right. Take it. And then you see how I just went down a little bit from the top here. Okay. Let's tie this knot. And let's just slide it up to where you want it to be. B. Ha, 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 ha. Oh, my goodness. All right. Let's try to get this straight here. Yeah, that looks good. And then just tie a knot. Another little sturdy knot. Ah, three times a charm. What the heck? And just trim this away. And then you can trim up the end, or you can leave it raggedy like that. Don't matter to me. And then it is done. Your cute little bead decor is done. So how cute is that? Ooh, more paint. All right, moving on. All right, y'all, this one is going to be pretty quick. We have some of these chip brushes. These came from the Dollar Tree, and you get two in a pack. So we're going to open that up and take one of them out. Now, for the top here, we're going to be painting that with some yellow acrylic paint. This color I found is yellow flame, and boy, is it bright. It is very, very bright. So all that we're going to be doing here is just painting this top part. If you get it on this metal part here, it's okay, because we're going to be covering that with something else here in a little bit. But I'm just going to paint this whole entire handle yellow. So our paint is dry, and now all I'm doing is I've got a piece of cardboard here. Which way am I going? Amber, stop it! I got a piece of cardboard, and I'm just going to draw some lines just to kind of help me know. And these aren't going to be perfect. I don't care if they're perfect or not. The little bees aren't perfect. Their little fuzzy bottoms aren't perfect. All right, just drawing lines here, like I said, just to kind of help me know where to paint. All right, so now we have our black paint again. Shake this up for a second, and then we're going to paint some of these and paint on some stripes. So now I just have a strip of felt. I just cut the whole piece along the bottom of the piece of felt here, and I cut that right at 3 inches. All I'm going to do is just take some hot glue here, just a little bit, not a whole lot. I'm just kind of putting it over the edge there, and then I'm just going to fold this over, about like that, about a third of the way. I'm just trying to cover up the seam, okay, so that when we glue it around his little noggin here, we're not going to have much of a seam. Okay, let's see, let's just glue a little bit here. Okay. And then let's just fold that over like so and work our way down. Trying to not burn my finger here. Oops. Let's put a little bit here. Okay. All right then. So now let's see. Let's put that right about there. That looks okay. All right. Where's the nose? The nose. Where'd the nose go? I'm just going to use one of these wooden beads. for a nose that we used. Oh, for heaven's sake, for the that beaded garland that we had a while ago. I'm just going to put a blob right there, and let's kind of put this down at the bottom. Let's take a look. Trying to not move it too much so it won't go rolling off. All right, that looks all right. And now this is kind of like just the little, what do you want to call it? Brim of his hat. There we go, brim of his hat. So now let's just kind of see where that's going to go. Because I still want you to be able to see that just a little bit. So you can see that it's a paintbrush. All right, that looks okay. So I'm just going to put a little bit of hot glue right around there. And I'm just going to stick that down. You can see the seam that I made. The seam is on the back. So just hold that down for a second and let that glue set up. Okay. Now I'm just on the back here. No, I didn't paint the back. You can if you want to, but this is going in my house. And I don't have to paint the back if I don't want to. Come at me. Like the label police. Put some glue right here. I'm just going to fold that over and hold that in place. Okay. Now I have this little sunflower here, and this just came off a bundle of sunflowers that I had gotten. I believe they came from Walmart, but they don't have a tag on them. You know, they're just in my stash. So I'm just going to put a blob there and stick it right there. Right there, right there. And it's pretty cute. Now let that glue set up. Okay. Now, as you can see, to hang it, all I did is, hold on, I just took a little piece of this Dollar Tree twine and ran it through right there, and that's going to be that. Now, once again, I'm breaking out the bee buttons, these bee happy buttons. These came from Joann's. Got them on sale. As you can see, they got like these little little bells on the back. Just cut that off. And then I want to glue one kind of like right down in the center of the, ooh, too much glue, woman. Like in the center of the flower there. I know bees don't hang around sunflowers. I know that, but we're going to call this another flower. It's going to be like a lazy black-eyed Susan. That's what I'm trying to say. My grandma used to call them lazy Susans because she said that they grew so easily, and even the laziest of people could grow them. But anyway, we'll take another one, and let's just stick one right about there. Glue on the finger. Right about there. And I think that's that. I think it's pretty daggum cute. All of my flowers have like little spots on them. I wish they didn't, but they did. And that's that. But anyway, here you go. Just something cute to hang up with your other bee decor. But if you want to see another video that has some more bee stuff in it, look down in the description box and in the pinned comments. I'll have a link to another video of mine where I show you how to make some awesome, easy bee decor crafts. But anyway, I hope that you enjoyed these two crafts here. They were a lot of fun to put together. If you would, give the video a thumbs up, click subscribe, check me out on other forms of social media, the links to all of which will be in the description box down below. And I will talk to y'all later. Bye!